They're marvellous to look at, and they're owned by John Gresham, who's come down from Humberside and brought along a selection of your collection. How many have you got, John?
Oh, about 300.
And where did you collect them from?
From arcades, pleasure beaches, piers, all over the country and abroad.
Are they expensive things to get hold of now, the old ones?
Extremely expensive today, but I've been collecting for about 7 years and they weren't so expensive 7 years ago.
Right, it's a shame, actually, that their value's increasing so much, I suppose.
It is indeed.
And you've obviously got a great selection of old pennies, like the one that I've got in my hand, to use.
One must have.
Yes, indeed. Right, what's this machine here, the floating lady?
It's a working model and one of my favourite machines.
Shall we see her doing it?
Certainly.
Whatever she does.
There she goes.
These working models were something that you'd see on many piers and things, or all piers, I suppose.
Yes, indeed, but very few as fine as that one. The figures were made in France, and it was assembled in 1907. And there's great delicacy of the features. The eyelids move, the mouth moves. I think it's a charming piece.
It's a lovely one, isn't it? I think we'll leave her floating, we'll leave her suspended and move on to this one. It's another working model, but it's somewhat later.
It is. This was made in 1938 by the two daughters of the gentleman that assembled the first.
Ah, right. Well, they've had a factory churning these things out.
No, they made them in their home in Leeds. They were made for the Tower Blackpool and they like to make a new working model every year.
This is. I can imagine a lot of kids liking this one, actually, because it's quite gory.
Oh, it is.
And the first bit of action happens on my side here.
Yes.
Where I think someone's about to lose their head.
They are. There it goes.
That's a terrible business.
It is.
And then over the other side, on your side, John, someone starts to get crushed in a minute.
They
the whole
do.
Thing takes a bit of time, doesn't it?
It does.
You get your pennies worth, don't you?
Oh, certainly on
value
this one.
Value for money. Anyway, there it is. Terrible death by crushing.
Yes.
We'll move on, I think. We can't take any more of those horrors. And this here, this is a bagatelle machine.
It is. A coin-operated one.
Can we put a coin in?
Certainly. Put the penny in. Press that.
Because, of course, you could get ones that weren't played at home, couldn't
you?
Oh,
yes,
that weren't coin-operated.
Mentioned in the Pickwick Papers.
When would this have been made?
Well, I estimate it's certainly prior to 1920 because of the wood and the heavy brass work on the end. That's a good score.
I got 500.
Very good indeed. Try another.
Now, the Americans claimed that they invented pinball machines, didn't they?
They did in 1929, but a lot were made in this country considerably before then.
There you are.
Here's an example.
It's a British invention.
Yes.
On to these, because I don't think I've ever seen these on piers and in arcades. Do you still get magic tricks today?
No, this one was made in 1939, but I have a particular love of magic and machines that do magic. Would you like to see this one operate?
I would indeed, yes.
Put a penny in.
Yeah.
And it'd be easier if I took that off.
Right.
See it better.
You turn the handle. I'll read this, because it says read this to explain the trick. An ordinary jam jar is placed over the disc in the table. Penny's dropping through. Now, what's happened to the disc? There you are, the disc isn't there.
It's gone.
And then the jam jar is removed. Lo and behold, the disc appears again. Fantastic, isn't
it? I like it.
It is, it's really good fun.
Beautifully made.
That's mystified a lot of kids in its time as well, I bet.
I'm sure it has done.
Yeah, it's a nice one. Right, we'll move on.
Okay.
There's a good one over here because I like the fact that they all link up with existing slot machines of one sort and another, and certainly there are loads in arcades now where you have to fire guns at various things and knock down targets.
Yes.
And this must be a very early one of those.
Yes, it is. We know when it was made, in 1914, by Mr. Mathewson. He made the actual mechanism. I believe the casing was made originally for something else, and he mounted it in this case, which to me is exquisite
workmanship. It is, it's marvellous. They tell me it's very heavy as well.
It is indeed.
But 1914, presumably there was a bit of a preoccupation with warfare. And that
there was. Why, Mr. Mathewson, who was a very astute man, made one concerned with warfare at that time.
Yeah. Did you both gunners have to put in a penny?
Both gunners put in a penny. You fire the guns by pressing these levers.
Yeah.
And the various men fall down if you score an accurate hit.
I see. And if you knock four down, then you get your penny back and the other fellow loses his.
That's right. That's right.
It's a good game, that one.
The name Bolland here, that's the man who refurbished these after the last war when they were discovered in a arch under a railway cutting.
And they wouldn't have been used then commercially from then on?
No, they have. Well, yes, they have been used. This one came from Folkestone.
Really?
Yes.
So, yes, up until how recently could you have found one of these in...
In operation, oh, probably 15 years ago.
Yeah. Let's move on to the next one, because this is a game that I like.
Yes.
A game of football. Obviously, you find those today, but this is an early one.
Very early, patented in 1896, and made by the same man that made the shooter you've just been looking at.
Right, we'll have a go at this.
There's the ball. You have to try and get a goal. I'm not so very skilled with this.
Oh, you've done it, though, either. You've done quite well.
Honestly,
you've won the penny. Shall we just play one more and see whether I can...
Why not?
I didn't get a kick, then.
Sorry. There you are. It's coming to you.
Oh,
nearly.
Kicked it back. Oh, you've won again. You're pretty good at this. Well, it is your machine.
I have played it before.
I would expect you to be rather good at it. You must have to have an inexhaustible supply of pennies, actually.
Yes, but I empty the machines when they're full, so I get them back
again.
True,
you can't lose. We'll move on to these. These are what we would now call fruit machines, wouldn't
yes.
we? What were they called in the early days? Were they called fruit machines from earliest times?
Yes, from very early days. But this type is known as a Cayley, because the Cayley Company of Detroit in USA were the first to manufacture this type of machine. You back a colour...
Yep.
In that case, black.
Yep.
Push down the handle.
Okay, I'll try and win this.
And if the black on the circumference of the wheel is underside the pointer when it stops, you win. You've won.
We've won 2 old pence.
Good.
That's absolutely marvellous.
What
would that date from?
This machine is not too old. It's only about 40 years, but they were making these in the 1880s.
And these are gambling machines, really,
yes.
aren't they?
Yes.
And at one time, that you weren't really meant to use them, gamble
That's
with
true.
Them.
That's true.
And that explains this one over here, doesn't it?
Yes, which is an early fruit machine, but it's disguised as a vending machine. Each of these columns had tubes of sweets in. When you inserted your coin, you could turn this and give yourself a tube of sweets, as well as pulling the handle, because it is, in fact, a fruit machine.
How old's that one?
I don't know the exact date. 1920s, I imagine. It's the first pattern imported into this country, 1925 or 26.
Right. Well, thanks very much, John, for letting us have a look at these marvellous machines. I think they're really great. I'd like one or two of them myself, I must say.
See you later.